wanted to design something different that would clearly fit into the Connecticut landscape, which it does, but something as you drove by would say, boy, that's an interesting home. I'd like to see what's inside of that house. We wanted light. We wanted you to feel that the outside of the house was coming to the inside of the house. Very light, very airy. It's all natural materials. So we used a lot of American cherry, reclaimed pine that came out of the rivers in the Carolinas. We wanted it to feel like a sanctuary, a place when you walked into it, it would soothe you, it would be quiet. As you walk down the main hallway, there's wood everywhere, and you get this sense of almost spa-like, like an old wooden ship, comfort, substance. It's 8,500 square feet. But when you go through the house, you get into intimate spaces. So you get into the family room, which is comfortable and warm, but not overly large to the point that it's cold. When we have dinner in our dining room, people are just amazed. It is just a phenomenal experience to sit there in this room with a 16-foot by 16-foot skylight above you, all the way up through the house. And just look out and see the sky. We have two islands, and you can walk in between them. It's a copy of the kitchen of the White House. Every cabinet in this house is handmade. We designed in a table, had a booth made in the breakfast area. All facing outside. We wanted the bedrooms to be in the corners, and then each bedroom has a deck, and it's a cute deck. It's a little triangle with a door, and you can walk out there. We wanted to get away from just having a wall in our bedroom, so we did a padded material wall. And then you walk into this bedroom that just opens up to the back of the house. There's actually a window in the shower. The other thing that's very interesting about the house is when you go downstairs, there are no pillars in the middle of a room. There's nothing obstructing you in the house. And there is an 1800 bottle wine cellar down there. What the deck allows us to do is be able to live outdoors. And the way we had thought about designing the pool, we would have raised the pool up. So you come off the deck, walk down a couple of stairs, and then walk onto the deck of the pool, and then have what we call the pool house, the studio house. We like to call it a modern arts and craft style house. There's a purpose to the design. It's all part of our goal to build a very good house.